I'm sure we all have a favorite food scene. The prison feast in Goodfellas, the Big Kahuna burger in Pulp Fiction, or maybe even that pie scene in A Ghost Story. Food scenes are an excellent way for filmmakers to communicate subtle information. The burger scene in Pulp Fiction, for example, is a masterclass in one character exerting dominance over another. Preparing food can be just as loaded. A character who possesses cooking skills is usually seen as suave and confident, while a character who struggles to cook is seen as incompetent and unsophisticated. Eating can also be very symbolic, like in this scene from Breaking Bad. Just hours before this, Jesse had committed a murder and witnessed another, yet he casually eats a big breakfast while Walter has nothing. This expertly communicates the fact that Jesse has become alarmingly desensitized. And the food itself can be very meaningful when it comes to moving the plot forward or conveying underlying meaning, or maybe most importantly, defining a character.
Let me get a bowl of raisin bran.
Great. Tea.
What does the contents of a character's plate say about them? Let's get a few obvious ones out of the way. Say you want to portray your character as ruthless and animalistic. A very rare steak should do the trick. Maybe you want to portray an adult character as immature.
Good morning, baby! Morning, Mr. Breakfast!
This is easily conveyed by having them indulge in a bowl of children's cereal or chicken nuggets or even ice cream. On the other end of that spectrum, food is used very significantly in Phantom Thread to express Woodcock's particular and obsessive nature.
A Welsh rabbit with a poached egg on top, please. Not too runny. And bacon, scones, butter, cream, jam, not strawberry.
But when it comes to food defining a character, maybe the best and most obvious example is the lunch scene in The Breakfast Club. In a movie that is heavily associated with the idea of labels, the student's choice of food says a lot about the personas that they embody. We have Brian, who is known as the Brain. Brian's lunch consists of soup, apple juice, and a peanut butter and jelly with the crust cut off.
PB&J with the crusts cut off. Well, Brian, this is a very nutritious lunch.
This simple, childlike lunch perfectly exemplifies Brian's timidness.
Did your mom marry Mr. Rogers?
No, Mr. Johnson.
Huh. Claire, who is referred to as the princess, has an elaborate sushi lunch.
What's that?
Sushi.
Sushi?
Obviously, this is much fancier than your typical school lunch and therefore represents her feelings of superiority. And then we have Allison, who is referred to as the basket case. Her lunch consists of a soda and a sandwich that she creates out of sugary cereal and pixie sticks. This clearly represents her unconventional, precarious behavior. But often, the correlation between character and food is much more subtle. We have to look at what the food symbolically represents. Back to ice cream communicating the idea of childhood. In the Florida Project, the kids have to often beg for money in order to share an ice cream cone.
Could you give us some change, please? We need
yes.
to buy ice cream.
Because we don't have any money, we just have 5 cents.
The fact that they have to struggle to achieve something symbolic of conventional childhood perfectly conveys their lifestyle. Now let's take this scene from The Shape of Water, where Liza feeds the creature an egg. What does an egg represent? Well, in many cultures, eggs are commonly associated with new life and fertility. This scene becomes much more loaded bearing that symbolism in mind. This is further supported by the fact that eggs are associated with Liza's sexuality during her morning routine. She is symbolically giving herself to the creature. Perhaps the best way to determine the significance of food in a scene is to replace it with something else. Imagine if Liza shared something like candy with the creature instead of eggs. How would this moment change? It loses all of its significance. So much thought goes into filmmaking that if you see food on screen, it's likely there for a meaningful reason.
The Fruit Loops and the milk are definitely representational of a colorful food and a white food. But it's just more that she's kind of like this really twisted girl who's got this sort of method.
So the next time you see a character enjoying a meal, take some time to consider why this particular meal is being enjoyed.